impact of heat, and public buildings must be equipped with air conditioning. There is a need for Russia's national action plan for the reduction of the climate change negative impact on the population's health, which will address, among the other things, the problem of the spread contagious and caused by parasite disease. This problem must be given to top priority. All the necessary vaccines must be obtained. All medical personnel must be trained beforehand. Priority should be given to the protection of poor and vulnerable groups of the population. Thank you, all of our ministers, for addressing the problem that we are having not only in Russia but in the whole world.
Thank you very much.
And thank you for your attention, Mr. President.
Thank you.
And just press that.
So now we're going to have the EPA director, Ms. Lisa Rodriguez, share with you her speech.
Okay.
Good morning, Mr. President. I, Lisa Rodriguez, as EPA director, recommend the following points to curtail global warming. Mr. President, it is clear that today the amount of damage caused by pollution has left us in a place of no return. Many will try to argue that global warming is not a real issue. Why? Because global warming and climate change has been something that has been continuously occurring throughout the years. Mr. President, climate change is real and has to be fixed today. While we cannot stop it, we can curtail its negative effects, which is why we should take action and follow my three plan action points. That being said, I recommend the following plan of action. First, we start using a clean power plan. Second, we start negotiating with other countries to protect the oceans. And third, we have to be stricter on our federal laws and punishment for those who harm the environment. To the first point, we need to start using a clean power plan now. Power plant accounts for nearly 40% of U.S. carbon dioxide emission. That's more than every car, truck, and plane in the U.S. combined. With a stricter enforcement on the Clean Air Act, our carbon emissions would be reduced by 42% and achieve 30% renewable energy by 2030. The United States can affordably cut global warming emissions, chart a course toward a clean energy future, and deliver significant health and economic benefits to all Americans. Next, we need to negotiate with other countries to protect the oceans. Land use is complicated, and we understand that. However, oceans are a whole different game. They can be protected by executive fiat, just like President Bush did in 2006 when he declared the world's largest marine monument northwest of Hawaii. Mr. President, you can do the same with other parts of the ocean and even negotiate with other countries to protect all oceans. Clean oceans mean a future for all of the people around the world. And remember that marine plants produce between 70 and 80% of the oxygen in the atmosphere. And if oceans are not safe, then the people are in danger as well, for we cannot live without oxygen. And finally, we need to be stricter on our federal laws and punishments for those who harm our environment. Your Honor, Mr. President, we should enforce our federal laws and punishment for those who harm our environment. Grant no favors to big companies. Money is not worth the cost of innocent lives. For these reasons, Mr. President, I ask that you choose and take my plan of action.